Hey, what's up YouTube? This is Benocha with a long overdue video review of the TDK 834 Trek Max waterproof speaker. What you're looking at is not the waterproof speaker. What you're looking at is the big brother, the TDK 3 speaker boombox. I've been having two of these for a couple years and this one just died on me from a circuit board. I'm going to send it in to get repaired. I still got one in the background though running for my TV. So I just wanted to demonstrate how big the little boombox is compared to its big brother. The sound that you would be getting from this thing is phenomenal. I'm gonna turn it on. I don't know how good my microphone's gonna react. I have it turned up all the way. And let's see if I can get some music streaming from my camera.
Scoop had that record, and I remember I asked him for it.
There it goes. So I'm playing Power 106 off of my boombox. So I'm gonna pause that. So if you look up at the top of this speaker, you got yourselves the NFC power button, volume controls, and if they showed in other videos, the volume controls actually toggle by dimming its lights about 5 times, I believe. So let's start off with the first light. Let's get a chance for that. We're gonna do 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, I guess 6. And then we start off to the next light. Focus, camera. Okay. So, if you're looking at, 5 lights, you're looking at, 30. So it would go from 0 to 30. You got your Bluetooth button. If you wanted to pair manually with the Bluetooth, but since I have Android, all you got to do is touch it right to this little signal, and it'll pair itself. You got your answer call button. You rewind. Play, pause, and fast forward. On the side of the unit, you got your ports. So let me open that up. It has a good seal. So now we're gonna look at the ports. You have your USB, you have your auxiliary cable port, charging port, and down here is your battery toggle switch. Gives you to turn it on or off. If you wanted to be running it off of the power and not the battery, you would turn it to the off position, and it would also be, it would not be charging the battery. You'd have to leave this switch on if you want to charge the battery and play the unit at the same time. Now, I did want to point out, I'll read it to you guys since it's just too small to show up on the camera. Or let's find out. Maybe not. This is a, for those of you guys that want to build your own adapters instead of buying another one, it is a 12-volt, 2-amp, positive center plug. The charging port is only 1 amp, so that's enough to charge either an Android phone, like a S3, S4, or an iPhone. This would not be able to charge a Galaxy Note 3 or an iPad. It just doesn't have enough current. You could probably run stuff off of it, but it wouldn't be able to charge it completely. Other than that, it does have some heft. It weighs about 2.7, 2.8 pounds. The battery that you would have to replace it with is down here on the bottom. So you'd have to take off 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 screws. Is that right? Yeah. You'd have to take off those 7 screws to get to the battery pack. Now, from the other videos that I've seen on YouTube, it did look like if it was 6 AA batteries that have been wired up in series. I'm not sure exactly what the voltage should be, but it should be at least 2800 milliamps. Later on, when the battery starts getting really crappy on this, I'm going to switch it out for some lithium ions and I'll put it on a video. But in the meantime, that was just my quick little review of the speaker. If you look at the back, you do have 2 passive speakers, which pretty means it's just sound holes. There's no real speakers in the back. And in the front, I'm not sure if you can see this or not. Let's see if I can get a better view here. How do you turn on the fucking flashlight? All right. can't. Okay, well, anyways, if you look on in the inside, the actual speakers, this is the middle of the side speaker. And the grill cutout, it should be here in the center. So the speakers aren't really lined up. That's something that kind of bugged me in terms of design. I don't know why they did it. Why didn't they opt for bigger speakers on the side? I guess they were just trying to conserve battery. But one thing that other people haven't mentioned yet is when you're playing anything off of this boombox. So you see right now, it does have a full battery. When the battery starts getting low, this light will start to turn red. Now, another thing you'll notice is when you're playing music, the volume will start to go down by itself to conserve battery. So you wouldn't be able to play music at full blast for the full 8 hours that it says on the box. You might be able to get away with 6 hours. You might be able to get away with 6 hours, you know, just on the third dot, like at about 50%. But at the same time, the longer you play this, the more the volume is going to go down until you can barely hear it, and then it'll die. So just giving you guys a heads up, if you either want to keep your charger around, or if you're at the beach and you want to give it a quick charge in your car, they have to have 12-volt adapters at Walmart and stuff like that, especially since this is a 12-volt 2-amp plug. So a lot of auto stores, Napa, AutoZone, Kragen, they would all have that type of adapter. So later on I'll be doing a demonstration of what it's going to look like on my motorcycle, because I just bought one of those too. So give me any questions, comments, posts, put it on the video link down below. Let me know what you want to know about the boombox, if you have any questions, or if you have any questions about this big bitch. And yeah, thanks a lot for watching. Bye.